हायर सेकेंडरी फर्स्ट ईयर 11th जूलॉजी द चैप्टर वन द लिविंग वर्ल्ड द टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज थ्री डोमेन्स ऑफ लाइफ. व्हाट आर द टॉपिक? थ्री डोमेन्स ऑफ लाइफ. थ्री डोमेन्स ऑफ लाइफ. This classification was proposed by Carol Woof the year of 1977. These three domains of life were classified into three. First one is domain archaea. This domain archaea includes single-celled organisms, the prokaryotes, which have ability to grow in extreme conditions. Like volcano vent, hot spring, and polar ice caps. Hence, are also called as extremophiles. Then, also we have seen what is methanogens. Some of the organisms are produced methane. They are called as a methanogen. And what is halophilus? Few live in salt environment, that is we call as a halophilus. The next one is the one domain bacteria. This domain bacteria are prokaryotic. Their cells have no definite nucleus and DNA exists as a circular chromosomes. And do not have histones associated with it. What is histones? Histone is a kind of proteins. They don't form in this domain bacteria. They do not possess a membrane bounded organelles except for ribosomes. That's a 70S type. S means Soviet Union. Already we have told you. Their cell wall contain peptidoglycan. Many are decomposers, some are photosynthesizers, and few cause diseases. And they are beneficial probiotic bacteria. They are beneficial probiotic bacteria. Probiotic means beneficial. And some of bacteria are harmful. They are pathogenic bacteria which are diversely populated. So that populations, that harmful pathogenic cells are present in the different conditions, different regions and different habitat. That is to say as a diversely populated. Cyanobacteria and photosynthetic blue-green algae which produce oxygen. Cyanobacteria and photosynthetic blue-green algae which produce oxygen. These had played a key role in the change of atmospheric oxygen level from anaerobic to aerobic during the early geological periods. So this bacteria had played a key role changing the atmospheric oxygen levels from anaerobic. Anaerobic means the fact that incidence happens through the help of due to presence of carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide can be changed due to process of oxygen functioning during early geological periods. In those days, this was happened by bacteria. The next one is the one domain eukarya, or we also can call as eukaryotes. So eukaryotes mean the organism which have well-defined nucleus. They call as a eukaryotes. Eukaryotes animals which have true nucleus and membrane-bounded organelles. Membrane-bound organelles. Membranes will be present in that one, in that parts. DNA in the nucleus is arranged as linear chromosomes with the histone proteins. What do you mean by linear chromosomes? The chromosomes just arrange as a rows aligned. That is because a linear chromosomes with histone proteins will be present here. Ribosomes of 80S, a Soviet unit type in the cytosol, and 70S type in the chloroplast. And mitochondria, chloroplast and mitochondria, it will be present in eukaryotes. The organism in these domains are classified under kingdoms, namely protista, fungi, plantae, animalia. Here, there of 1987, Cavalier-Smith revised the six kingdom into seven kingdom system. Here you can find different systems in your textbook. You can find first earlier the naming of animals, the nomenclature of the animals are done by in three domain system, that is archaea, bacteria, eukarya. Then afterwards five kingdom system appeared, the traditional five kingdom system appeared: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. Then the five kingdoms, just after five kingdom, the six kingdom system were appeared: Bacteria, Archaea, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. Then after six kingdom, there is a seventh kingdom system were appeared. Then Eubacteria, Archaea, Bacteria, Protista, Chromosta, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. So these are the seven kingdom systems were followed. Finally, they are used for fifth kingdom of RH Whittaker classifications. It's a Cavalier-Smith revised the six kingdom system into seven kingdom system. The concept of super kingdom was introduced and revised to the seven kingdom classifications. The classifications is divided into two, that is a super kingdom, that is a prokaryota and eukaryota, and seven kingdoms, two prokaryotic kingdoms, that is a Eubacteria and Archaebacteria. So, and the five eukaryotic kingdoms were Protista, Chromista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. Here there is a small information which already you have studied. Curd is one of the best sources of probiotic. What is probiotic? Probiotic means beneficial bacteria. Okay, if you just mix the curd little bit in the boiled milk at night, that milk will be converted to the form of curd. Okay, that is what we call as a probiotic bacteria, which are friendly bacteria that can improve our health. Example, lactobacillus species. These lactobacillus bacteria are only helpful for converting the milk into bacteria. The next one is our here taxonomic hierarchy. Here, what is taxonomic hierarchy? In biological classifications, the taxonomical hierarchy includes seven major categories. So, what is biological classifications? Naming of animals in a systematic manner or systematic way. That is because of biological classifications. The taxonomical hierarchy means steps or methods of naming that animals includes seven major categories, namely kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species, and other intermediate categories. In this, in between, if the characters are more in this taxa, in this seven taxa, they undergo for the intermediate categories. Intermediate means subdivisions of that one. Subkingdom, great, subkingdom, then great, divisions, subdivisions, subphylum, superclass, subclass, superorder, then suborder, superfamily, then superfamily and subspecies. So in this method only, the biological classifications are following it. We'll see one by one. Here, as we have seen, major seven categories, namely kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. Whatever the characters, the species they have, that animals are just come under genus. Whatever the characters, the genus, animals they have, that come under the under the category of family. That's a taxon. Whatever the characters, the family they have, they come under the categories of order. Whatever the characters, the order they have, they come under the category of class. So whatever the characters, the class they have, that animals, they come under phylum. Now whatever the characters, the phylum they have, all these animals, they come under the kingdom. So in this way only, the classifications of animals are done it. We'll see the highest taxa and lowest taxa, what is that one? Yeah, the lowest taxa is the one species one. Okay, highest taxa is the one kingdom. We'll see one by one. We'll see the first one, the basic classifications of animals. That's a species. We'll see one by one. So here, species is the basic unit of classifications. So kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. Here, the species is the basic classifications in the taxonomical hierarchical system. Underline this one word, they'll ask you. Dash is the basic unit of classifications. One word, important one, just underline. It is a group of animals having similar morphological features. What do you mean by similar morphological? Morphology means external features, external structures. The species, those whoever have the external characters, structures would be similar. They come under this species. It is a group of animals having similar morphological features. That is a traits, means generation by generation. That is because of traits. And reproducibly isolated to produce fertile offspring. So this organism can reproduce. This organism can reproduce and produce offspring. What do you mean by offspring? Young ones only we call as offspring. Okay, the deer. Male deer and female deer. They undergo for reproduction. They produce one offspring, the young ones. That's what they say here. There are some exceptional animals which can produce sterile offspring because of mating with a closely related species. Okay, in the picture, just we'll see. I'll show you the picture. Yeah, this is the one. But these animals, they don't consider as a species one. Here, hinni and mule and tiger and liger. So these are all crossbreed. These are all crossbreed. Here, if you see hinni, it is a cross between male ass and female donkey. So it is not considered as a species one. The next one, mule. You see the mule, it is a cross between male donkey and female horse. And next one is the one, it's a liger. It's a cross between male lion and female tiger. And tigon is a cross between male tiger and female lion. So these species are not, these animals are not said to be as a species. That's what they say here. There are some animals, there are some exceptional animals which can produce sterile offspring. What do you mean by sterile offspring? These animals cannot produce their young ones. They are sterile. Inability, sterile means what? Inability to reproduce. That is because of sterile. Because of mating with a close related species. Because they are related, close related species means what? It is a artificially mating one. Not naturally mating. Artificially man-made. And just they put the male ass and female donkey in a single cage. So the artificially they made this one. That is why it is called as a sterile offspring. So the next one is the one genus. It is a group of closely related species which have evolved from a common ancestors. It's a group of closely related species. Okay. Whatever the characters the species they have, it is a group of related species which have evolved from common ancestors. They have common ancestors. In some genus, there is only one species which is called as a monotypic genus. In some species, only one type will be there. They are called as a monotypic species. In some species,